Hello, welcome to Enots Engineering. I'm Alan. A few weeks ago I showed you this rotary head or dividing head. This was a prototype that's made out of MDF. I showed you how it worked and explained that I was going to make one out of aluminium. This one can be used on the lathe or on the mill, but we had some problems with this being MDF. When you come to clamp it down, it didn't clamp very well. It would tend to crush the MDF rather than clamp. So we decided to make one out of aluminium. And today we'll see how we've progressed with the aluminium version, what problems I had. So let's go into the workshop, see how we made it. Because I'm taking the plates on and off, and I have six plates that go on and off, I've bolted some large washers to the table, clocked up the plate square, moved the washers in till they touch the plate and locked them, pushed the plate up against the washers, bolted the plate down, and I've just checked that it's square to the table. So next time I can take the clamps off, take the plate off, and the next plate will just go up against the washers, and I know it's square when I'm machining this outside edge. This is how I've set up for doing the plates. I've put a big thick washer at the back there and two at the side, and I've touched the plate up against these two and slide it back to the back one and clamp it. So when I machine along the front edge to my zero on the table, I know that all the plates are machined exactly the same size. Okay, what I'm doing at the moment, I'm doing some slots around each panel, and these are clamping holes. That's so that when this is on the machine, I can put a clamp bar in the hole to hold it down onto the machine. And I'm doing the same pattern on each side. These are so, if I have it on the side, I can use these. And if I have it on the end with the chuck on the top, I can use one on each side. Now this is the finished pocket for the stepper motor. So all I need to do next is drill the four holes that bolt the motor in and complete the hole in the middle for the register and the spindle to go through. This is one of the two plates that are inside the box, and this holds the stepper motor. I've just finished drilling the holes for the stepper motor, and this one here is the center point where I want the bearing race to locate for the spindle. As I want them both in the same position, I've set my parallel strip here, which is against these stops. There's a stop block at the back here. I know this corner position. I can then put another block in, locate it up against there and this side, and the centre hole will be in the same position relative to the outside. Now I thought I'd be able to do this on my lathe, but the problem I've got is my lathe is only a 5-inch centre height, and this one is 5 3/4 to this corner. So I won't be able to put that on the faceplate and bore out the bearing bore. So all I've done at the moment is centre drilled it, so I can pick that up with the centre at a later date. And I'll do the other one now. So I know that centre drill is in the same position. Now on this one, because it's the opposite, in other words, when I bore the bearing bore, I need to put a lip on the inside so the bearing doesn't go straight through. This one, the nip needs to be on the other side, so I need to bore from the back of this in. So I'm going to drill an 8mm hole straight through so that I can pick up the centre when I have the plate mounted on the other side. Okay, this is the project so far. The stepper motor goes in there. I made a pocket so that when the motor goes in, it goes right in, recessed in here. And the four holes are there ready for the screws to locate the stepper motor. All I need to do on this is bore the register out. That's a hole through there, 38.1, and then the stepper motor will come in a little bit further, about 2mm, and that can be bolted on. This is where the main bearing is going to go, on this side, so it will go in from this side with a recess to stop it going through. The sides, so each side has these cutouts machined in. I'm going to drill four holes which line up with these partitions so I can screw into this and hold that plate to this. Then I've got the back plate with the groove for the partition. Goes on there. And the top plate goes on there. And all these plates will be held through the top, through the side, to the centre plate. On the front, there's the other plate. That will be screwed all the way around, and that will have the bearing for the spindle. And on the back, inside, we'll have the pulley on the spindle. Just drilling the holes now for the screws. I've already drilled all the holes in the panels where I want the screws to be. Now I'm drilling through into the internal panel, the end panel, to tapping size.
just set my depth stop on the machine so that the countersink stops at the right depth. The holes that I drilled in here, which were 5mm, I've opened up to 6mm, so the countersump screw will go through. So all that remains is to put the countersink in. To do that, I've slowed the speed down to 75 RPM. Just below the surface. Next job is to tap these holes around the block. So I've just countersinking. And then I follow that up with the next tap. That's that side done. Do that on the four sides. Just assembled the case. You can see here I've used countersunk screws. These slots are for clamps, so I can clamp it down in that position. Use these to clamp it with the chuck goes on the top here. So I can turn it around any position. All the sides have got the same markings for clamps. The next jobs to do is on the stepper motor, there's a register, so I need to cut on the other side of this plate the register. I need to bore out the two holes for the bearings in here and on the faceplate. Now I've looked at the lathe to do that, and the problem is I haven't got the swing. The only other option I have is to get a boring head and bore this out using the mill. So what I thought I'd do, as this one is not so important, once I get a boring head I can test it out on the smaller hole to see how accurate I can get with the boring head in the mill before I go on to the bearing holes. So not many jobs to do. One, two, three bores. I've still got to make a back door. This was the tensioner that I used before, which is far too big. I found this bearing, so what I'll do is modify the offset so that fits the bearing, and then so once I have the belt fitted across the two, I can then position the centre hole for this so that I can put tension on the belt. It doesn't need a lot of tension being a tough belt. Well, that's it so far. It's taken a lot of time to machine this and get this to this state. At the moment I'm stuck awaiting delivery of a boring head. Well, that's it for today. I hope that was useful, and we'll see you next time on Enots Engineering.